too jagged, all right? Bringing it back together is gonna be more difficult. This is where that gap might not close. We might need other materials to help with healing. For example, artificial skin, might need grass that'll be done. That type of wound most likely has the greater chance of scar. So skin repair is a, have y'all ever thought about this process of what happens when you breach yourself to the outside world? You will now. So now, like every time something happens, paper cut, splinter, whatever the case might be, y'all are going to be like, oh, I don't know what's happening. And y'all can watch it. It's really cool. Watch to see how quick the blood clots and all this other type of stuff. Watch it. Okay. All right. And then all those little processes will be happening. Cells will be rushing through the area. Chemicals will be given off. Granulation tissue will form. Gaps will form. It's really cool. Now, you'll definitely get more into talking about this in part two when you get to the chapter on blood, because of the properties that are in it that will help with wound healing. What's going to happen as we get older? Everything's going to slow down. And as we age, all these tissues that we have, the bone, the muscle, the nerve, the connective tissue, the epithelium, every single bit of it is going to change. All right? Now, at this point in time, they have lots of things that they'll tout to you that will slow the process down, reverse it. It doesn't. Okay? At this point in time, that is not the case. Our cells are going to divide more slowly. The collagen fibers, the toughest ones in the body, they're going to become more irregular in their structure, meaning things are going to break down. In the areas of the body where they are in high numbers and give lots of strength and support, it is going to affect them. For example, tendons and ligaments. Elastic fibers will begin to break down. The problem with that, calcium ions, somewhere we don't need them to be, will attach to those elastic fibers, make them even less elastic. The area of the body that this becomes a major problem is the aorta and the large artery, causing hardening of the artery, which is going to decrease blood flow, all the other things that come with it. Because of these changes in the collagen and the elastin, we're going to get the reduced blood supply to the tissue. Arteries are not going to be as pulsatile, meaning the blood flow is not as great. Hands get cold, feet get cold, legs get cold, okay? Ever been around the older person and they've got on gloves and thick socks and wrapped in a blanket, and you're like, okay, this is the reason why. We're going to see wrinkling of the skin. One of the major fibers under the skin's tissue, and that connective tissue, is collagen. If collagen is breaking down, it is going to result in wrinkles. Because collagen is the rebar for bone that concrete sits around, bones are going to break more easily. The rate of blood cell synthesis. Now notice what that's telling you. Red blood cells, white blood cells, platelets. The making of them. Synthesis means making of them. Slows down. It's just just not as present. Injuries, they're not going to heal like they used to. In your 20s, they healed overnight. In your 50s, it's going to take 3 weeks. So, that's what we get to look forward to. Right?
Right.
Okay. So, I think for lab 6,
we only have a